Hey Shayna, this is your stroke coach, Steve Friedering, and I'm looking at a little bit of your pulling from this morning just to give you some hints. I think for the most part, you still have one of the most technically advanced strokes on this team called the swim team. I know you don't love pulling, but I think that's just partly because you're going through the growing stages of getting used to pulling, especially as much as Mark has you pull. There is a problem with this. As you can see, you're pulling straight down with your elbow rotated out. You and I have worked on this a lot. So this didn't help you any, but now you're turning around and grabbing the water. So from there to there, you need to improve that. From here to here, you're pushing all the way through. And you're kind of letting go a little bit back here because you have to, because you're not strong enough yet, but you will be. It's not even strength, you know. It's more like you're pumped up, your muscular endurance isn't there. And then you're really trying to rotate here and push the water backward. I think a pretty good job there. And pushing all the way through and rotating early. And that's good, not easy to do with a pull buoy in. But then you're upside down with this hand. And then you're going to see what you're going to do is come back, try to come back at it. And that's pretty good. I think that hand could be maybe a little bit farther underneath you. This is a hard view for that. Body alignment's really good though. Eye position's really good. Hips are really good right on the top. Rotation's excellent. Your rhythm's good here. There is a hitch caused by what you do with what we just talked about with that right hand. So there's a little bit of a hitch here, which we don't really like to see. If you're totally exhausted, I guess that's the place to hitch. But it looks like you're pulling, you're doing a pull up here with your arm coming back instead of rotating early. And now it's rotating, hands a little face toward the bottom of the pool in here. And that could probably be a little bit better. Then you bring it in where you're strong near your body and push through, and that pushes you on your side, and that's good. All right, so technically, it could be a little bit better. Rhythmically, it could be a little bit better. Tempo-wise, I don't see anything spectacular yet. You aren't either. You know you went about a minute slower today than Mark asked you to go, so you're just getting used to it. They're getting used to you. And don't worry about that. As long as you're doing the best you can every day, when you take off the pull buoys and paddles, you're going to find you're going to have to accelerate your hand in order to go faster, and that's kind of a nice thing. We've talked about that a lot with the fast paddles that you use. Take a quick look at Ledecky and Titmus here. Technically, you really got to give a little bit of advantage to Titmus technically. She's shorter, so sometimes it's hard to tell how much better she is. It's not a lot better. They're both, in this case, let me see, get it back here a little bit. Yeah, this is good right here. Okay, so coming in here, let's see the recoveries. Just because, you know, Mark said you would talk to him about recovery, and I think it's fair for you to do that. We're going to have some different opinions. You can see Titmus a little bit higher to the water, not really high. You can see Ledecky coming off the side. I think this makes her beatable. Not in the 15 yet. There's so many variables, you know. If you're going the mileage that you're going right now, you're going to find that you're better even with a lesser stroke. But if you're trying to beat these two ladies, you're going to have to continue to get better at it. But you can see Ledecky lifting her head here. That makes her beatable. And then Titmus a little bit more over the top, not specifically over the top, but certainly recovering with a lot higher hand than Ledecky. Let's see her at full speed. Here, here, here. See the right hand's better. Again, they're sort of conserving energy here. This is not the end of the race yet, although it's getting there. They're starting to pick up legs. It's not quite all out. They're going to make this turn, and you can see that Titmus is moving forward better. Her head being in a better position helps. Into the turn, they're equal. Out of the turn, Ledecky stayed under longer, but that doesn't mean she went farther or faster. So remember that. That doesn't make you faster just because you're down there longer. You've got to actually do the job. Ledecky, in this case, wasn't able to, and Titmus took her. The rhythm here is very good. There's no gliding or loping, as you can see, and this is how the whole race needs to be swum, as far as I'm concerned. You push all the way through, and now she's just going to go right into the wall. And she just used energy just a little bit better by using stroke just a little bit better. They are very connected. So both very close to the world record there. So there you go. All right. So hopefully that helped this morning. And we will see you soon. Okay. So we're done.